I'm the public information officer for the Pearland Police Department. Appreciate y'all being here. We have a update we would like to announce, and we're really asking for the public's help in the shooting investigation that happened at Cole's Flea Market last night. Just to recap, last night around 5:34 p.m., Pearland officers were dispatched to Cole's Flea Market at 1014 North Main in reference to a report of shots fired. When they got there, they located five victims. We had a 10-year-old Hispanic male, a 14-year-old Hispanic female, a 37-year-old Hispanic male, a 16-year-old Hispanic male, and an 18-year-old Hispanic male. They were all transported to nearby hospitals. One of the victims, the 10-year-old boy, he passed away at the hospital. Preliminary investigation revealed that there was a disturbance, some type of altercation that occurred at Cole's Flea Market between two Hispanic individuals. During the course of that altercation, shots were fired, exchanged between at least two handguns. We can confirm that the weapons used were handguns. We believe between two or three handguns were used during the course of the firing that was going on at that time. We're uncertain to the number of rounds that have been fired. Again, the scene is still being processed by our criminal investigation division. As y'all have seen out there today, it's still a very active scene. I can tell you that the 10-year-old, the 14-year-old, and the 37-year-old victims were innocent bystanders caught up in the crossfire as a result of the altercation. The 16-year-old and the 18-year-old males are continuing to be looked into their involvement into the shooting that happened at Cole's Flea Market. And again, they're being actively investigated into their role, if any, in the what happened there at Cole's Flea Market. Here's where I need y'all's help. At this time, there is an active arrest warrant issued for David Negrete, 3/10 of 2004, for aggravated assault with a deadly weapon. He should be considered armed and dangerous. We're asking anyone with any kind of information about his whereabouts to contact the Pearland Police Department tip line, 281-997-5828, or Missouri County Crime Stoppers at 1-800-460-2222. We just posted on our social media photographs. Again, there's several photographs of Mr. Negrete, and we're asking the public to please help us find him. I was just told that Texas Crime Stoppers, in conjunction with Governor Greg Abbott's office, has offered a $15,000 reward for the arrest and capture of Mr. Negrete. So again, this is very, very important for us that we get this person into custody as quick as possible. The investigation, our detectives have worked all night to put this information together. They are continually to develop leads and more information. We're so thankful for the public's help leading up to this point, and that's all we have at this time. Does anyone have any questions?
Yeah, Chad, were you guys able to get this guy, the suspect, based off of surveillance footage, or was it the tips that came in through that tip line?
So a combination of the interviews that happened with witnesses and victims, as well as surveilling footage that they had there at the scene, has identified this gentleman as one of the persons we need to locate and put into custody. It's at this time he is identified as one of the shooters, yes.
What can you tell us about his criminal history?
I don't know anything about his criminal history at this time. Again, we're mainly focused on getting him into custody as quick as possible.
So do we know, was he the only one to fire a weapon?
No, we believe there's at least one more, if not two other people, that actually had handguns and may have fired those firearms during the scene, yes.
So does that mean that one of, like, the other shooters would have been one of these other people who y'all are still talking to, or others involved?
Yes, as previously stated, we're looking into their involvement in the shooting. Obviously, if we get more information, we'll put that out to you guys.
But you do believe that at least one of those other people had guns and fired their weapons?
We're looking into their involvement. Yes, ma'am.
So a total of possible three suspects?
Possibly three suspects, yes.
Okay. At the beginning of the press conference, you said how many were involved at the beginning? Was it?
We had five victims that were shot at the scene, three of which are considered innocent bystanders. Two, the 16 and 18-year-old were also shot. We are looking into their involvement further into the altercation that happened there at Cole's Flea Market.
Was the altercation, was it like a larger altercation?
No, it appears to be between a small group, two to three people, and you had other people there. It was the closing time for the flea market. There were people there going about their regular day when the shots were fired.
So this is what you're looking for. Go ahead.
I don't have any of that information, no, ma'am.
And so you believe this suspect who you were looking for was also shot?
The suspect we were looking for, we have no information that he was shot, no.
Chad, you just kind of talk about, I mean, it's, we're
we're close to the holidays. I mean, this is a flea market where thousands of people kind of come, and unfortunately, a 10-year-old little boy lost his life. Kind of talk about how this is tragic for the city of Pearland.
Extremely tragic for the city of Pearland, tragic for Cole's Flea Market, tragic for all the families that attend that flea market, tragic for the families that work at that flea market trying to provide a living for like you said, the holiday times. And to know that this senseless act of violence, whatever caused it to happen, which we will figure out what caused it to happen, is extremely sad. It's tragic. That's the exact word that took place, and senseless. Tragic and senseless, and that kind of stuff doesn't happen in Pearland. And it's a very sad day.
What are y'all going to do next? I mean, is the flea market have plans to open up again this weekend?
I'm not sure. I know the scene has been still locked down. Eventually that'll get released and we've processed it completely. It'll be up to the flea market to determine how they proceed. I know there's a lot of livelihoods that are dependent upon that flea market opening again.
What do we know about this guy, this suspect? Does he have a criminal record? Is he from the area?
I don't know his criminal record. It's my understanding he is fairly local to the Pearland area. I don't have a current address. Again, the main thing I need you guys to do is help us push that information out to try to find him.
And I apologize if you said that, but the other people who were shot, do we have any idea how they're doing? Are they all expected to survive?
My understanding from what I was told is that I don't know which ones had to go through surgery. My understanding is the 37-year-old male, I believe he was released. The 18-year-old person that I spoke of, the male, I believe he was being released today. I'm not sure about the other minors. I don't want to speak on their status at this time.
Why is the Governor Abbott's office sent out a release saying that they're going to offer, the state of Texas is offering the $10,000. Do you know why the state is kind of invested in this case?
I'm not sure. That was information I got literally as I was walking out the door just now. So you would have to look more into it. But a 10-year-old child was killed in a senseless manner. So any support we can get, whether it's financially or the public, is very welcomed in this case. Again, we deserve justice for this young person.
Do we know the immigration status of this suspect?
I don't know that.
I know in the governor's press release, he had mentioned that this person could be like the 10 most wanted fugitive. Are you able to confirm anything like that?
The post that you're talking about, I literally found out before when I walked out the door. My guess is that he's high on a priority list because this person is responsible in some way, possibly, of the death of a 10-year-old child. I would think that ranks pretty high on a most wanted list.
Of course.
Yep.
I mean, how difficult was it for you guys to just see this and obviously tell this mother that her baby was killed?
I mean, I don't think there's anything that can prepare you for it. Our investigators and officers are extremely professional at this department, but yes, we have families. There's a job that needs to be done, and these men and women step up every day, and they understand that it may be something they have to do. But do y'all have kids? Okay, so just put yourself in the shoes of those officers. There's no easy way. Nothing prepares you for having to make that conversation, okay?
And is it possible that the suspect could face murder charges?
Again, this is the initial charge that's out there right now. That can always change depending on how the investigation unfolds.
And these are some young guys. I mean, we're talking about a 19-year-old suspect. The two that are involved, they're 16 and 18.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they obviously, somebody had a gun. So these are young kids. There's consequences when you have weapons and you go to a flea market where there's thousands of people.
I could not say it better myself. You're absolutely right. That's information I heard. I have not been, it hasn't been confirmed to me.
And because y'all are still interviewing him, is he going to be released or is he going to be brought in for questioning?
I'm not sure. The investigators, that's their thing. Like I said, they've been working all night. I don't know if they've slept at all, but I'm promised that's something they'll be looking into.
Do you know if any of these five people were actually working at the market?
I'm not sure the status of them. I know it was during closing time, but I don't know what they were doing there.
And are you guys going to release
I don't have the names. That's something we'll have to figure out with the investigators whenever that time comes.
As far as calls to that flea market, do you guys get a lot of calls to that flea market? Is that a busy spot for you guys?
I mean, there's a lot of traffic that goes there, but violence like this doesn't happen at that flea market.
Of the five, do we know how they were related. Are they related? Is it one family, three families, five families?
I don't know the relation between the victims at this time.
And as far as, like, you know, a plea to the public, a plea to those who know this person. Mm-hmm.
I think that's why we're here, is to reach out to this community, the Pearland community, the Houston area community, and help this guy get into custody. Again, there's a long investigation ahead, but we need to find him. There's a reason why the warrant has been signed, and we're asking for y'all's help.
Chad, you guys have a number of tips that came in through that tip line from yesterday?
We've been getting calls on the tip line on social media. I don't have a number or exactly what's been said to the investigators, but it's an active line. It's being manned, and we encourage people to contact it. You're going to be left anonymous. I understand people get concerned during this time, but you don't have to provide your information. All good? All right, guys.